Man, it is cold out this morning.
Spent some time. Now we're going back to work. This here Mercury, we're going to do a window regulator, a fan assembly, hood shocks, and a thermostat. I'm not sure if we'll get it done today, but we're going to try. The hood shocks, so I can take my pry bar out of there. And then we'll see about the regulator. Let's do it.
I did the first hood shock already. This hood shock, I'll show you what I'm doing. I just popped a little clip off so you can get it off, and the other one you can leverage off. Use your other hand to hold the hood up just in case. Pry bar should not be needed. Look at that thing.
Like a brand new hood.
Something like that. And a thermostat is just one of these here little doohickeys. It's got a little vent. I usually try to put that in the highest part. If the thermostat's angled back, I put it at the top. If it's angled this way, I'll put it over here, if that makes sense. And then it's got an O-ring, cast aluminum O-ring seal. I don't do anything special with these. You don't have to disconnect the hose. You don't even have to unbolt the engine cover if you don't want. You do have to make sure that there's no corrosion or contaminants on the seal surface so that it's going to seal up when you put it back together, right? Just look at that thing. Isn't that nice? Off the seal out of here first. It's easier to get the thermostat out. Gravity check the seal. Put this here. New seal without dropping it. I almost dropped it too. That would have been terrible. Because that's the new one. I need that one. Everything's nice and clean. I didn't feel like unbolting the cover. Just use an extension normally. But you can just pop these off the ends here. It goes back about a half inch or so. Gotta get that one just touching. And then I do the other one. Alright, that ain't going anywhere. Now, putting these back on. Put out on bolting the engine cover. That's the tricky part. There you go. Brand new car. Well, brand new thermostat. A couple 8mm hold the tank. And the reservoir for the power steering. I might have to take this hose off here so nothing gets damaged or anything and get some room to get this out. This you can just push back out of your way. Electrical connector. I gotta see if the new fan assembly comes with the resistor or not. Fan control module, if you will. I wonder if these pliers will get this clamp. They're not made for it, but it doesn't stop me from trying. Nah, it's not gonna work. Okay, it's gonna be more time than it's worth. Use the proper tool for the job, Jimmy. That's what I'm saying. These are like one of the most fragile things under the hood of a car, is these coolant tank nipples. I like to disconnect them just in case. It's just one more clamp. It'll spill a little coolant. I got my catch pan underneath, so. This clamp should lock open, I believe, too. I can hear that snap. That means it locked open. The old may you pick a Rooney. Oh. I'll save some of that. It's an 8mm on this fan, but I gotta pop some clips out of here before I can lift this out. Cooler lines are in the way too, but I think there's a hose is clipped into the. They just thought it'd be a good idea for the fan to hold the hose up because the hose is about 8 feet long. lovely. Come on now. I know at this point they fit out. It's a dime for a dance. I have sliced my hand open and smacked my head and done a bunch of injuries this week. Smashed my shin working on my truck. So, I'm not sure what is holding it at this point. I am a little bit struggled. Alright. There you go. A lot of stuff catching on stuff. Let's take a break. Good set.
Let's get this thing open.
Piece of cake. That even looks like the right one.
Yay.
Fragile, handle with care. That's the lower hose bracket. That's the cooler line bracket. It does come with the module. That's good. Right. Don't fight it. It's gonna happen. Alright, I got work to do in this car. Let's go. Let me in. These freaking cooler lines are stiff, man. I think they want you to take them out of the radiator, but I don't want to, so I'm not gonna. How about that? Come on! Oh my goodness gracious. Seems easy. Whew. There's two sets. Now pop that lower hose in. Make sure I trap the lower hose when I do it. I can lift it underneath afterwards, I feel like. It's easier to lift the car up and do this from underneath.
Come on, what?
The lower hose will be hooked up to the tank. That'll be lifted back up. The power steering. There's a little slot on the bottom. A little tab. And one screw. Or bolt, if you will. Now for our tank. It's gonna spill, that's all right. It'll be okay. Dig up the clamp. Basically trying to do the thermostat, the radiator fan, hood shocks, and the window regulator in an hour and 10 minutes. Yeah, we'll see. I'm working fast, but not like ridiculously out of control, because I don't wanna have to do it again. Like what happens with fuel pumps modules and stuff sometimes. You know what I mean? That's what I heard. That's not gonna go without snapping me in the finger. I know how it works. Trust me. There you go. Now I can move it without locking it open. You can tweak on it a little bit. Just don't squeeze it too much. There you go. That's perfect. All right, same thing. A little tab on the bottom. See that slot? Tab on the tank sits down in that. And there's a second one over here. And then one bolt. Get that clamp going. We'll see what that door looks like. I'm gonna put some coolant in this first before I move on. Come on, clamp. I don't want to lock you. I'm gonna have to try to open you back up. There you go. Check the time. All right, 35 minutes so far. Close. What I'll do is I'll leave that right there, get that window regulator in, then we'll fire this up and recheck the coolant level. I'm not sure if they're heading to the beach or they're having a problem with the window. Maybe both. I'm gonna guess both. This armrest is pretty jacked up. I didn't do it, just saying. Couple sevens. I think there's some sevens going on under here. Caught it. Not like a cat. Can't get past me. Oh no, that's a different size. Yep. That's a 10, I think. Nope. Is that a Torx bit? Are you guys messing with me now? Oh my goodness gracious. It's a Torx bit. I'm trying to get this done today, but it's not really cooperating. That's all right. We'll do what we gotta do. There we go. Let me get the screws I can get while I'm here. Two. Now I just gotta get my Torx. Come on! We got good at. They couldn't even put a nut on the outside of it. Just the Torx in the center. So 10 won't even, oh, I guess I bumped my knuckle again. Damn it. Took the Band-Aid off because I washed my hands. It's not done healing. Oh well, what are you gonna do, man? Something under here? I don't have to go look at instructions. You guys know how I feel about instructions, right? Oh, can't have blood on the door panel. That's bad. I'm gonna disinfect that. I might have a virus or something.
Still got a half an hour left in the day.
But feels like there's something behind here. So this has to remove. That's all there is to it.
Feels like it wants to snap hooey.
I thought it'd come out of there, but it felt like it wasn't gonna. And I didn't want to snap hooey anything. Because when you snap hooey, you end up with Mr. Gluey. If nothing else, you'll be bleeding and getting out the old soldering iron, and you'll probably be crying.
Man, I'm just on fire today.
I knew I felt something holding it. I was not imagining it. I don't know if the regulator's even here yet. These are all riveted in. I don't know if I'll get it done tonight. Let's grab the bit driver. Get the speaker out of our way. Stay with me. Since these are all riveted, I get myself a nice 1/8-inch punch. Punch the center of these out. Then you can drill them a lot easier. If you try to drill with the steel center, it's really gonna give you a hard time. Usually punch out pretty easy. Not always. Try not to just totally smash the door in, so it takes a little love. Might not look like love, but that's what it is. Let's get the speaker out of the way. Things are about to get more serious. We're running out of time here playing around. Jeez, man. They usually pop right out. You turn the camera on, it gets harder.
Why is that?
I don't want to hurt your drill bit hitting it with a hammer, but it'll come off. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Now I can get this silly thing out of my way.
The scary thing is hammering them out of the glass.
That's fun. At least they bolt the top in. I don't know why they don't bolt it all in, because, I mean, Ford's done this for, like, what's been 20 years on these Grand Marquis and Crown Vics. They're all riveted in. I don't know what the deal is. Yeah, what was probably happening here is the door was flexing. Down here, it doesn't flex as much, so. For the glass, I might get my angle grinder and a cutoff wheel and just cut off the head of the rivet so I don't have to hammer on the glass. The problem is I'm in a little bit of a rush, and if I'm rushing, that's when bad stuff's gonna happen. So, I'm not gonna take a risk. Should have taken it off. Wanted to see if it would work. You don't know till you try. Let's get the cutoff wheel. Lower the glass down a little bit. You gotta get the pool supplies out of the way. Put that in the car for them in case they need it for the kiddie pool. I'm just glad they didn't use duct tape, because usually it's duct tape and then I feel compelled to try to get it off the paint for them. It makes a mess. You're way better off with packaging tape or something if you're gonna do something like this. I know Milwaukee. Keep in mind, I'm changing the regulator, so I have to be quite so careful. But still didn't take much metal off of it. Even if I was reusing it, it'd be fine. If you're only replacing the glass, just be a little careful not to take too much metal off. Yeah, that one's a little trickier because the door's in the way.
Let's see if I can fit this in there.
Nope. The motor's in the way, which I have to take that out too. It looks like that's already kind of fallen out of there. Let me punch those pins out and get those rivets out of my way. That's out. Honestly, if it was a bolt-in regulator, I'd be done. No exaggeration. But because you got to drill all these, you complain about it on your YouTube channel, and it takes longer. That's good stuff. That is good stuff. Ow! Man, I am just... It's going to look like The Walking Dead when you watch my videos. Hope you don't mind gore. You know what you do? You hit it with a hammer and you see what happens. That's all. I really don't want to break the glass. Doo-da. All right, guys. There's two 11 millimeter bolts and this thing's out. The part's not even here yet. I didn't know that. That's why I had all those other parts except the window regulator. So that's going to be here in the morning. I don't think I was supposed to try to do it, but I was very motivated because I'm only having a 3-day work week, so I wanted to try to get as many hours as I could. Got to get the two 11 millimeter nuts out of the top. That's the only thing holding it in right now, and I got my airbag holding the glass up so it won't be open all night till they work on it tomorrow, and they'll finish up tomorrow. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I appreciate you watching, and I hope you'll torque the like button or subscribe. And I hope I see you in the next video, because you're awesome. Have a happy new year.